Hey everyone, how's it going out there? My name is Matthew Krolmager. If you clicked on this video, you're going to see the second half of Ecuador Manta documentary. I'm not quite sure just yet on how many videos I plan to upload to YouTube on Ecuador Manta just yet, because I'm trying to put pictures and titles and a bunch of samples of the music of all the albums that I have, and it's definitely been quite a big project. So I've been trying to cut and paste pictures and things together to give you guys a really good documentary. So before we continue, I have something I want to share with you guys. Now I want to show you some of the instruments that have been used to make this music. I want to show you guys some of my instruments. The bamboo wood flutes. These are kind of fragile. This particular flute came from Ecuador Manta. In the past years, when Alfonso has brought in his band here, I've helped him set up. He's been short help, and I just like helping out, I guess, because I'm quite the fan of the music and all that, and it's really inspired me. But I go around and I play this music myself, and I play along with the music. I don't sell the music because it's not right to do that. But I just go around and I play, and I provide music for private parties, little small functions, those kind of things. But you know, the smaller the bamboo notes are. The smaller the pipes, the more high-pitched noise you're going to get, and the bigger, the more lower-end noise you're going to get, but it all sounds really good. I play this one the most. So anyway, you know, these are all made out of bamboo. I've bought in some of these smaller ones. They're like kids' toys or whatever. These are just impossible to play. I've tried. They're just really, really hard to play. So now what I plan to do here is to give you guys more music here. I'm giving you guys just about 20, 30 seconds so you can get a feel of this music, and if it's something that you want to bring into your own home in the future here. So let's get started with some music, and then I plan to bring back Alfonso and another musician for some more interviews. So let's get started and let's have some fun. And please comment and subscribe as well. And I will get back to you. So have a good one.
Thank you. depending the for where event we have to be performing. Like for big events, we are about 5 or 6 musicians on stage. Like for small festivals, we do between 2 or 3 musicians.
Okay. So you plan to come back to Bismarck again?
For sure, yeah. Basically, you know, it's a lot of people love our music, and a lot of people wants to share, and they appreciate our job, our music, so of course, why not? That's what's part of our work too, you know, to share our culture and music. Okay. In the end, it's from South America to all the people in the States, you know.
Okay.
Had the opportunity to listen to us.
Okay, so tell me, how many CDs or albums do you currently have for sale?
We have 11 right now.
Okay.
11 CDs. So and then we're planning to get another one soon. Yeah, another one.
And Mexico. Do you record the music yourself? Or?
Not myself. We get together and we have to go to the studio.
Oh, okay.
Studio. Sometimes we start working our CDs in Ecuador, and then we finish here in Minneapolis. So to have a really high quality recording.
Okay. So tell me about some of the clothing, some of the jewelry, some of the stuff, other stuff that you sell, like the jewelry, the clothing. Is it true that you guys do a lot of work with wool? Some of the colors and designs of some of that stuff?
In South America, especially in the Andes, like Bolivia, Peru, and Ecuador, most of the people work with what it is around. For example, with jewelry, it's a lot of beautiful minerals, beautiful rocks, really beautiful stones and stuff. So they work with that, just working with amazing. They do an amazing job, okay. Like in Peru and Bolivia and Ecuador. So most of those 3 countries, and the same thing, those 3 countries, they have amazing handicrafts. They are really Italian people. They're actually the native people in those countries. So they make all the clothing and stuff, so the weaving made wool. And so they make all the jackets, sweaters, so that's why we have to bring those products to sell here. That way we can support them to the people in those countries to provide job for them too.
So these clothing and stuff, are these things handmade?
Everything's handmade.
Okay. Can you tell me a little bit about the EcuadorMantra.com, what you have on there, your website?
Well, the website is like all the information, you know. Every person can log in our website and find out about the musicians, about our CDs, about where we're going to be performing next, history about the band, and we're going to add more information. We are planning right now to put together about touring for people who are interested in traveling to South America. And we'll be the ones to guide people, to take them, because our people are interested to, after they hear us, after had the opportunity to listen to our music, and lots of people it is interesting to have the chance or the opportunity to go there and see the real Andes is, because they have people through their music, they love it, and they say they want to see exactly where they come from, and how, where they come from, the music exactly in South America. So we're planning to put together, see if people can travel into there. So we can show them where we come from, what is our country, how it is, and all the things, you know, products. Mm-hmm. Musicians like ourselves, all musicians, really know musicians there. And, you know, they also teach them how we live there, how our people live there and work, the handicrafts and stuff.
Okay, well, let's see.
Mm-hmm.